I might be anyone, a lone fool out in the sun. Your heartbeat of solid gold, I love you, you'll never know. When the daylight comes, you feel so
The collapse of the Spanish economy has created a rough time for women athletes. Spending has been cut, and sponsors are becoming tougher to find to fund sporting endeavors. The struggle is forcing Spanish athletes to leave Spain in search of other teams in Europe where they can make a living. One sport in particular is that of basketball, where years ago, the women that played on the national team were able to make a living off of their participation in the sport. But today, they are forced to seek teams outside of Spain. Many basketball teams representing various cities across Spain are no longer able to compete due to lack of funding, with players even required to make down payments to play. Retaining players on teams also becomes difficult, as the end of the season often means significant debt, and they pursue other outlets for their talents in the sport outside of Spain. This loss of talent will become a detriment to all of the Spanish national teams as standards of play are lowered. Sponsors, the media, sports management organizations, and trainers are guilty of not taking women's sports seriously, therefore influencing the attitudes of broader society to also not take women's sports seriously. The current status of women as coaches or captains in Spain is a topic for discussion. For example, in September of this year, Gala León, a female, was chosen to be the Davis Cup captain for Spain. This is a men's tournament, and Gala León, being a woman and being chosen to be a captain for a men's tournament, has been quite controversial. Most of this controversy has been coming from her own team. Rafael Nadal and his coach Tony Nadal have both spoken out about this topic, and neither is supportive of the decision to make Gala León captain. Tony Nadal instantly criticized her lack of communication with the players. This lack of support for a woman from her own team reflects the lack of respect for women in sport in Spain today.
The underlying theory concerning the divide in men and women's participation in sports is the feminist theory. Gender roles play a significant part in dictating the male's power and the clear gender divides that can be viewed in sports. Women are not expected to become athletes. Rather, they are expected to be mothers and to not behold the competitive spirit required of an athlete. With the majority of the general public following these strict gender roles, it is causing women's clubs and federations to suffer from lack of participation.
Through a survey conducted with 70 participants regarding sports in Spain and the involvement of women, we had some very interesting findings. Of the 70 participants surveyed, 47 did not know if there was a Spanish women's national football team. That is 67%. Of the 70 participants surveyed, 60 did not know if there was a Spanish women's national field hockey team. That is almost 86%. Of the 70 participants surveyed, 49 did not know if there was a Spanish women's national basketball team. That is 70%. We asked the participants, choosing from football, field hockey, and basketball, which sport they believed women should play. 8 of them answered field hockey, 21 of them answered basketball, and 41 of them answered football. This is an interesting result because, as we have been discussing in class this semester, football is typically thought of as a game for men. Women's football gets very little recognition in Spain. We also asked the participants if they would be okay with having a woman as a coach for football, field hockey, or basketball, and only 3 participants responded no. Of the 3 participants that responded no to this question, 100% of them were male. We asked participants if they have ever participated in a sport with a woman, and astonishingly, only 2 responded no. One of these 2 respondents was male, and one of them was female. And this female was one that had never played sports before. 97% of respondents had played a sport with a female at some point in their life. The final question we asked the participants in our survey was if they thought boys or girls were better at playing sports, or if they were equal. 14% said that boys were better, that is 10 out of the 70 respondents. None of the participants said that girls were better than boys at sport, but 86% of respondents said that boys and girls are equally good at playing sports. That is 60 out of the 70 participants.
¿Crees que las mujeres y los hombres deben practicar juntos o separados en baloncesto?
¿El baloncesto?
Sí, baloncesto.
Y probablemente separados, porque los jugadores de baloncesto suelen ser muy altos y muy brutos, y el baloncesto es un deporte de contacto y es posible que una mujer se pueda lastimar más fácilmente.
¿Mujeres que juegan baloncesto?
Pues está bien, porque también todos tenemos derecho a jugar, aunque sea si son chicas o chicos.
¿Juegas baloncesto?
Sí, sí, en
el ¿En la escuela?
Aquí,
¿o
sí.
aquí?
Sí.
¿Cuándo?
Los viernes.
¿Con solo chicas o con...?
Con chicos.
Con chicos. Oh, pues, las mujeres juegan baloncesto.
Que está muy bien, que es un deporte que ayuda a hacer equipo y que, bueno, pues las mujeres se jueguen a baloncesto y compitan y como cualquier otro deporte.
¿Crees que es más difícil para las mujeres a jugar a baloncesto?
Quizás en... Quizás si hablamos a nivel profesional, las salidas que tienen, quizás sí que es más difícil, pero supongo que porque la gente que más apoya son hombres y los clubes de hombres tienen más dinero y todo, pero creo que deben jugar suficientemente bien, ¿no? Está muy bien que jueguen.
Bien, bien.
I might be anyone, a long fool.
In the London 2012 Olympic Games, of the 17 total medals won, 11 of them were won by female athletes. Overall, there is a general trend of increasing participation in Olympic Games by women. Of the 250 athletes representing Spain at the London Games, 114 of them were women. Even with the success of the women of Spain during the Olympics, little media coverage was dedicated to women, and the media coverage that did focus on women referred to them as girls.
There is a large need for the expansion and respect of women's sports in Spain. Spain does not have the fan base or the interest in creating professional women's leagues that can compete around the world. An example of this is of Maite Cazorla of La Palma de Gran Canaria, Spain, that has just signed with the College D1 Oregon Ducks in the USA. Kelly Graves, the Oregon head coach, says, "In my opinion, Maite is the best point guard in her class in all of Europe and one of the best in the world. She has an outrageous basketball IQ and uncanny vision on the floor. She can step out and shoot the 3 as well. She's a tremendous leader." This is from a press release from the Oregon Ducks on November 17, 2014. Graves says that Cazorla is a great player, the best in Europe from her class. And although I am grateful that she will be bringing great skill to the U.S., it is a shame that she will not be able to display this skill while playing in her home country of Spain. Great players such as Cazorla are forced to leave Spain if they want to develop further as basketball players and to have success in their sport, because Spain does not support women's athletics in the way they deserve to be treated.
Many of the London Olympic Games medal winners began to advocate for additional resources to be put into women's sports while highlighting their own difficulties they face and the lack of institutionalized sports available to women. These female medal winners also advocate for additional media coverage, claiming that with increased public awareness, there will be increased public interest. There is also an organization called Support for Olympic Sport that helps athletes pursue their Olympic training. They also negotiate for payment that is equal for both men and women based on the sport they participate in. While organizations can be helpful to female athletes, there is a lack of female participation on these boards. Increasing the number of females making decisions on allocating funding will increase the chances of equality for women. Spain has also submitted to become a candidate to host the 2018 FIBA Women's Basketball World Cup. José Luis, president of the Spanish Basketball Federation, wants to take the opportunity to provide the Spanish women's team with the same opportunity as the men's team had with Spain hosting the 2014 FIBA Basketball World Cup. It will also draw public awareness to the sport and, José Luis hopes, increase participation, promote fan support, and show the values of equality to the people of Spain. Physical education classes in schools are an area of equality for boys and girls. Both genders take part in activities together, and it can become the starting point for creating equal opportunities for both males and females as the future comes. In 2009, the Spanish Federation of Municipalities and Provinces completed a project to raise awareness at the local level of gender equality issues in sports. They brought this awareness through giving suggestions for local sport organizations on their structure, local sports provision, sports associations or clubs, sports at school, and sporting facilities. Administrators monitor changes being made, pinpointed areas that needed work, and introduce suitable remedies to resolving the issue. The sporting world will continue to change and adapt in the many years to come.